University is supported by some of the world's most well-known and influential thought leaders.
This enterprise is extremely ambitious, it's realistic, and it could be considered historic. I think it could be a historic episode, a historic movement in the great transition that we are facing today toward a better, a more sustainable world. We'll do our bit.
Budapest, a city of grand culture, science and history. A city that serves as the cradle of an unprecedented mission, the Giordano Bruno University, a state-of-the-art global institution with the objective to foster a new consciousness, defeating ignorance and providing affordable world-class education to young people everywhere.
This is what we need today. We need campuses which are free from violence. We need university students who are robust and strong in their physically strong, emotionally refined, intellectually sharp, and spiritually elevated youths of this world. It's an ambitious aspiration of all of us.
Because the goal of human evolution is to live in right relationship with all of humanity and life, through love, but also wisdom. And I truly feel that this new university will achieve that very result, and with many, many smiles.
The Giordano Bruno Global Shift University was established by an international group of thinkers, business leaders and scientists, headed by Ervin László, Louise Goodman and Francisco León.
It's my pleasure to introduce the first keynote speaker of the day, Ervin László. In addition to being a renowned scientific philosopher, theorist in many fields, and with a long list of publications, awards, honors, Ervin László is also the founder and president of the Club of Budapest and chancellor of the Giordano Bruno Global Shift University. Please welcome Ervin László.
Thank you, Lars, Francisco León, distinguished members, Your Holiness, Lady Montagu and others. It's truly a moving moment for me. I'm very touched. It could be a historic moment to launch an enterprise that has a chance to do something crucial in the world, to make a contribution to mastering this tremendous challenge that we are facing, the challenge of transforming this world so it becomes sustainable, fair, peaceful, with solidarity, a higher consciousness and a new ethic. An unprecedented challenge. Major transformations have occurred in the past. They've usually taken fairly long times, decades, perhaps centuries. We do not have time anymore for a natural process to occur. We have to accelerate it. Ladies and gentlemen, I am convinced that we live at a crucial moment of the history of humanity. Never has there been a period in human history as critical, but also as exciting as today. Never has there been a greater responsibility on young people and on those who claim to educate young people as today. We don't want to teach, we want to empower young people to learn, to recognize who they are, what this world is. A big chance, a big task. We are committed to it, thanks to the founders of this university, thanks to my colleagues. We are there to do this in the coming years, and thanks with all of your help. Thank you again for coming here and helping us bring this to fruition.
Francisco is an entrepreneur, a businessman, but his passion is really in education, and he is currently serving as the chairman of the Club of Budapest Education Committee. Please welcome Francisco León.
I remember I was amazed to realize
that those young people of all ages from 16 to 70 years old were doing nothing there but contemplation of nature and the universe. One of them took the lead and with cosmic dignity told me, "Look, mister, we are here because we do not like the world that is out there, and involuntarily and unrequestedly inherited from our parents." I thought about the urgent need of our generation to put on trial our entire symbolic, religious, political, and predatory-oriented economic civilization.
Our next keynote speaker, Lou Goodman, received his PhD at Northwestern University. He has been dean at the American University International School of Service since 1986, and we're very pleased to have Lou Goodman with us at Giordano Bruno University now. Please welcome Lou Goodman.
There's a great awakening. People all around the world know that they want to hold their futures in their hands. And many of them know that their leaders have been holding them back for such a long time. One of the necessary pieces is education. And as I travel, as you all travel, I'm sure you know that every parent that one encounters is looking for a way to be sure that their children have the very best education possible, that their children have the tools to be autonomous individuals, to put their lives together in a way so that they can conceive of dreams, and they can dream dreams, and they can move ahead to realize those dreams in their lifetime, and that they can contribute to the largest society through those dreams.
The university aims to create a high-quality accredited platform for young people on all five continents, empowering them to do well for themselves and at the same time do good for humankind, accepting the historic challenge of building a world that is sustainable and peaceful and does not subordinate people to narrow and obsolete economic, political, or sectarian interests. The Founding Congress in Budapest presented and endorsed the mission and the goals of the university.
The aims of the university are close to me: to bring understanding and solidarity between young generations on the planet by means of high-quality, affordable, modern online education. I wish the Giordano Bruno Global Shift University success in fulfilling its noble tasks.
Living in the consciousness of the interconnectedness of all life, the Earth community will be a healthy starting point for all decisions made towards a sustainable future. I trust that the Global Shift University will contribute to this forgotten truth.
I'm particularly thrilled by the goal you have set yourselves to throw open the doors of quality higher education to young people from low-income families across the world, and that your approach is founded on multiculturalism. You hold in your hands the dreams of millions of children: access to accredited, top-level higher education. Thank you, thank you, thank you. God bless you.
At a special ceremony, special guests were awarded honorary PhDs at the Founding Congress. They included Indian-American medical doctor and global thought leader Deepak Chopra.
So we have to go beyond mere information before a science which is based on a total, lack of emotionality or meaning or purpose, a science that is sterile and looks at the world as independent of us, to see that actually scientific truth, mathematical truth, is not different from poetic, musical, or artistic truth. When we find that, and when we embody those Platonic values deep within our collective psyche, then we'll have an education that'll bring about the age of wisdom.
British ethologist, anthropologist, and UN messenger of peace, Jane Goodall.
It was the chimpanzees that enabled me to reach into the hearts and the minds of people around the world. I want to bring their voice, too, into this space. And when chimpanzees are happy and excited and things are going well, they don't just say, thank you, I'm proud, I'm honored. They sound much better. And actually, Irving, come up here on the platform a minute, because when chimpanzees are excited, they make sounds like this, but also...
Nobel laureate, astrophysicist, and cosmologist,
right, things,
George Fitzgerald Smoot.
The 2006 Nobel Prize winner in physics. It is our pleasure to give the doctorate honoris causa to Professor George Smoot. Dr. Laszlo.
Well, it is my pleasure.
I think it's that we have to start making a change in the way universities are, because the cost, it becomes more and more important for everyone to have an extended education, because the world is getting, there's more knowledge, there's more technology, there's more things going on in the world, you're communicating with more people, you have to know more history, more other things, and so you have to have an advanced education, and yet it's very expensive, it's grown, the cost of education has grown, so you need a way to make this education acceptable to people, no matter what their economic background.
U.S. futurist, author, and media personality, Barbara Marx Hubbard.
When I graduated from Bryn Mawr in 1951, I was told that most of the problems of the world had been solved. 1945, when the United States dropped the first bombs on Japan, I was 15 years old, and I realized that we had come to the end of one phase of consciousness, because consciousness with this degree of power in a self-centered state would destroy the world. Conscious evolution, I believe, will be seen as a breakthrough as great as self-reflective consciousness was. What it really means is not just the evolution of consciousness, but that evolution itself is becoming conscious as humans.
And Nobel Prize winning economist Robert A. Mundell.
Well, I think the idea of a global internet university that's emphasizing the education of youth in different countries that are not empowered much with education, I think it's a great idea. And we'll have to see how well it works.
I think it's going to be the most exciting and empowering function that I have yet heard of happening on this earth. I am so glad to still be alive. Thank you.
How many more are there who do not know that they are dissatisfied, but would be available, would be open to ideas that tell them, here is your chance to do something.